Alright, it's time that we're going to see what the Flipper Zero can do to act like a battery that's going to power 24 LEDs. There's going to be 7 LEDs on this side, blue ones. There's 7 on this side that are blue ones. And in the middle here, we got our tin lead bar graph right here. It's called a tin lead bar graph right here. There's 10 little LEDs in it. And we're also going to use this on plus 5 volts, direct 5 volts coming from the Flipper Zero. So when you do that, you must provide resistors, 220 ohm resistors. I got 24 of them. These ones here are really, really crammed into this little guy right here. Really, really crammed, but there's 24 altogether. If we're using the direct 5 volts, we have to use resistors for your LEDs, alright? And now these little guys here, these little LEDs, they're RGBs. We're going to use them with the Flipper Zero's pull-up, pull-down resistors. I assume that's what they are, because I don't need resistors when I use the other GPIOs, like the other examples I have done before with older little LEDs. But this here is going to be your red, your brown, your green, and blue. I got the same thing for this side. Red here, brown right here, and then we got green and blue right here, okay? RGB, RGB, you can see that. Now, first thing we're gonna do is, out of these 35 bunch of wires we got, we're gonna hook these up first. These are what we're gonna hook up first, all right? These are gonna go in each LED, of the blue LEDs, and they're going to go into the positive rail. So in the end, the wires are going to be bent up something like this along the side of the breadboard, okay? Positives are going to go into the positive part of the lead, a little short end, the anode, and this part here will go into the breadboard positive rail. It will go right here, okay? That's where this little puppy's going to go, right there in this positive part, all right? So we're going to start putting these in, and that way we can work on this and we can check the power as we go when we do this first set of lights here. Okay, that's all going to the positive rail, see? See how it's going like that? That's one LED. And I got them spaced every two apart. Now you got to make sure put it always in the positive or it won't work. Nothing will happen if you put it in the negative. Just that it won't turn on. That's all. It just won't turn on if you do that. I'm going to put this one in here. See how I'm going on the positive? I'm going to work on the positive side of the anode. That's all I'm doing right now. Before I add any power to this, we're going to hook it up. Sometimes you stick these wires in, you gotta try and get them straight as you can. It's easier on the breadboard too. You don't want to jab them in there. Don't you have to help it. Now we're gonna go for these. It's time consuming this is, but it's worth it in the long run. You're gonna watch. We're all gonna do it together here. Okay, see how we got these all going in the positive so far? Two wires to put on this side. One wire left, sorry. There we go. Making sure now I'm going to hook up this side. And then we'll check it to make sure everything's okay, all right? That's what we're gonna do. check each piece of work as you do it. Everything works in stages, or steps you want to call it. I work everything in layers or stages or steps. That way I'll know what does what and why it does what. If a mistake goes wrong, I can quickly fix it. Check our fun so far. We're going to use the 5 volt. The direct 5 volt. And I'll show you where that is in a minute. There, now we got this all hooked up here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take our little flipper, and if you can, there's the very last GPIO port on the very far left of the flipper zero. This is going to be your positive, your direct 5 volts. This here, that's a direct 5 volts right there, okay? That's directly 5 volts. Now we're going to play this puppy down again. Into the positive right here, because we're going to need other wires to do other things. So we're going to put it in the next hole down. Now we need our black wire for our ground. You see the ground right on the very far right on the left of the left side of the GPIO. There's a 5 volt, and on this side here. On this side here is your 3 volt side. This is your 3 volt side. This is your 5 volt side. We're using the 5 volt side, all right? The left side is the 5 volt. The right side is the left. This is the 3 volt. The right side is the 3 volt. Left side is the 5 volt. So let me make sure I got that clear. Now we're going to go like this again. Lay this on its back. And then what we're going to do, we're going to go into this negative ground here. Okay? So what's going to happen is this is going to power all this. It's not going to power the little tiny RGBs yet because there is nothing on them yet. But now we can just check our power. So first we're going to turn on our Pi. I got a Raspberry Pi too, sorry. We're going to turn on our flipper. And we're going to go like this. Hold it for a minute so it turns on. And then your middle button, go like this. We're going to go down the GPIO. Right there, you see the GPIO? We're gonna go there, make sure I'm all lined up. Now where it says here, 5 volt on GPIO, see that right there? Now we're gonna go like this. We wanna turn it on. And we're on, but I'm not hooked up. Did it again, put it in the wrong hole. See what I mean? It doesn't do nothing when you go like this. You put it in the negative, it's supposed to be positive, it doesn't do nothing. Okay, that's all I did by accident. I just put it in the wrong hole because I'm reaching over. Okay, now like I did before, I got 2 holes down, a hole down because I'm gonna put the power where the LEDs, where the RGBs are. Let's see how we got so far. We're connected okay? Right? Now it's time for the center guys that we're gonna light up, okay? And so far our work checks okay, everything's okay. Now we're gonna turn this off, Let's be, always be safe when it's off. Better to be safe than sorry, right? Now we're gonna take our 10 yellow wires. These 10 yellow wires are gonna go into here. Now this little bar graph, it's sometimes a little judging to look at where the actual holes are in here, because the lights look a little off on the holes. So it's always good to check the first one. That way you know you're lit up all right. And we're on the positive still. So we're gonna go like this and back up. Yep, that's on. See how that works? Now we're gonna turn that back off. And I'm just gonna keep adding the yellow ones again. All right, it's gonna be a little time to zoom in, but it's gonna be worth it when it's done. And, whoops. Didn't want that to happen. It's called Barrel of Monkeys, I guess. You pick up a bunch of wires, they all want to come over here. We're trying to get one. Real game Barrel of Monkeys. I had that game when I was a kid. Whatever you want to call it. Toy game. Now we got to hook all these up here. It won't work if I'm not. Let's go and work one way. Okay, what they are is an LED, a diode, and diodes only work one way too. But they're just a diode that lights up. That's what an LED is, it's a diode that lights up. Diodes can only work one way. And reverse power. Now we're just going to continue to hook this up, and then we're going to check to make sure it's all working, alright? Make sure everything works, and we'll work on our RGBs. And then we'll play with the thing. Once we got it all hooked up, we'll play with it. Fun, isn't it? Mm-hmm. If you want to get into electronics, sometimes you just gotta get your hands a little dirty. You gotta hope for the best. Expect the worst sometimes, and just hope for the best. That you hooked up everything right, and nothing's seriously going wrong. If you don't want to do that, that is all you want. Just don't do anything stupid. Watch what you do. Turn off your power. Before you even work on anything. It's always good to, always good practice. Always good practice. Now we got that hooked up. Now we're gonna make sure we work again, okay? All lights are on, except for my RGBs. Now here's where we're gonna have a lot of fun. Now we gotta think of the electricity as being water again, okay? Now we need some hoses. We need some more hoses, okay? And what these resistors do, these little 220 ohm resistors, water wants to try and gush. It wants to come out of everywhere. I mean, water will look for the path of least resistance, so does electricity. Just that electricity moves a lot faster than water, and how it behaves in motion, I have no idea, but in nature, everything loves curves. Nature loves curves. Everything's curved, even light. So I assume electricity actually spins too and curves as well as what's in here. But what's happening is power is going to be gushing out of water. And if there's too much water going through these LEDs, it'll blow them. It's like a fish tank, you know, filling up with water, and it fills over, but only these guys will blow up and burn out. So that's not good to do. Now, nothing will happen to flipper if one of these do burn out, but if I had something on that took time to burn out, then I'd probably lose part of my flipper. And I don't want to ever do that either. But this is like what you can think of water. These resistors hold back a lot of the pressure. If there's too much pressure coming out that the lead can't take it, these resistors hold back the power, something like a faucet in a tap. When you turn the tap higher and lower, that's what these do for the water. And now the water, when it actually keeps pouring, it has to go back into the source. It has to go back to where it came from, just like a real water turbine coming from the ocean or lake. It has to go back in once it's being used. It has to go back in to recirculate. So it's always constantly looking for ground. And it's also looking for the path of least resistance possible. That's all it does. Now we're going to turn off this again, and we're going to hook up the rest and check, okay? Now here's where the fun gets really, really good, where I got to think of the water. Okay, I got this like this. Now what I need to do, take this guy, put him on a negative. Okay, see how he's on the negative rail? Because this little guy here is going to be an extra hose. And this hose is going to come out of here, and it's also going to go into here now. Now what we'll do is we'll check it again to make sure that my little hose is right. Yep, so far it's right. See how that? See how I got it going from the water's coming out of here, going into here, and this is actually the tap turning on the water to let the water come through. Because either one of these wires I take out, no water will go through. So I don't know which wire is more important than the other, ground or positive. I just think both are equally important because it's like yin and yang. One just can't be without the other. Now, we'll turn our lights off again. We're gonna add these little negative wires now. Okay, these little negative guys here, these are gonna go to this guy. Right in the middle is where it's gonna go, and it's gonna go on a negative rail. Okay. And then we're going to take this guy and do the same with him. So we got everything marked that we need. He's also going to go on the negative rail. Okay. He's on negative. Okay, and that's like that. Now we're going to take a white wire, okay. Now I'm gonna go from left to right. Yeah, I'll go from left to right. That way it'll be easier on me. Okay, now what I'm gonna do here is we're gonna go into this red pin right here. When I told you red, and what red will do is it will go into here. Gonna go into C3. Now what we gotta do to handle this, we go up like this, push your center button, and we're gonna go all the way to C3. Now see how it lights up red? Even though the camera looks a little different, but it's actually lighting up red. That little LED is lighting up red. That's an RGB right there, okay? So far that works. Yeah, I can go. Now I can use this little tiny reset button or a little back button, they call it. And I can go all the way back like this and still check to see if my switches work. And my switches still work. Everything still works. Now we're going to hook the other one up, lay this back down, move these wires out of the way. Now I need once you got the middle wire in your RGB, the other wires are pretty much, you can just line them up right away. Now we'll just Let's check this. I believe it'll be called, let's push all. That makes yellow, okay? It's blue and green makes yellow. So we're gonna go like this. And B3, B2, see how B2 is green? And then we got C3 is red. See that? Oops. We got C3 being red, okay? But I can't do both, I can't show you both on here, it's hard. Or you can show you like this maybe. You see that? That's green. Red. That's C3 and that's green. Now we're gonna hook up the blue, okay? So we're gonna turn this off again. That's like that. Now we're gonna hook up the blue. Now notice here, that I didn't use any resistors because what I believe this has is what is called pull up and pull down resistors, like I mentioned. It's got built-in resistors. Or I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing without killing any of these LEDs. But on the direct 5 volt, I cannot do that, which I'm using for all these little LEDs here. Okay? But on a direct 5 volt, I do not do anything. Now let's just see if this works. So we're going to go back to here. We're going to go to C3, B2, blue. And we got blue to work now. Okay, that would be B3. That's B3, B2, C3. We got C3, B2, and a B3. All right, that's RGB. That's RGB. Okay, that's what that is. Now we got that working. Now we'll hook up the other one now. So we'll just go out of here and make sure we're double safe to make sure that things go. Now we're going to hook up our other one. We're going to do exactly the same thing. Nothing went wrong. I just want to arrange this a bit different. The first, that can go there. The second one can go there. And that can go here. So we're going to just change the addresses around. So we'll make sure it all works. Anyway. Yeah, see, I just wanted to change the pins around so I can keep them more oriented. That's like that. That's all. Yeah, these are the other ones. That's 7. A7, I think. I didn't see that so small. But I got all these wires here all hooked up. You'll see as I play with it on the bigger screen. I'll be able to see it better myself. But you'll see all this once you get it all hooked up. Okay, that all works. Now we're going to hook this one up. Do that like that. Now we just play this kind of game again. It's already oriented because of the negative wire there. And I want the very first one to go in the executive order. Just like before, they're only in order at all. Check our work again. This is on this side. There. Now we got everything. I've exhausted all the ports on that side, as you can see. They're all exhausted. Okay, they're all, I used them all up, except for the right side, the 3-volt side. I'm not into that yet. I don't know nothing about those pins yet. But this so far is going to be like a giant battery. Now what's going to happen is, when we turn some power on the actual computer, we are actually going to be using the 5 volts right off the bat. Now we're going to plug this little guy right into here. This here is the screen that we're going to be using, and I hope that you can be looking down to see all that. But as you can see, I'll show you, I have no control of this turning on or off. As you can see that I have no control, to turn that off. That'll automatically stay at 5 volts. But here's the fun part. This is where the battery is to test that, is what I just showed you. But here's the fun part. We're going to go back up to here. We're going to go do like this. See that little light just flash when I go like that? You see that? Now, again, if I go like this and I pull away, it'll stay on. And then I go like that and it'll turn off. Now I go this way. We got green. I go this way again. We got blue, and then if I go down here, we got this red here. We go like this, we got this, we go like this, and we got that. Now, if we want, I can go like this, leave that on, go back to C3. Leave that on. You see that? Now if I go to here, I can make it be yellow. Every time I push, I can make it be yellow. And then what I can do here is go down to here, V7, this, that will turn cyan. See that? That one turns cyan. And now we'll just go back to here, take that off. Go back to here, take that one off. Oops, didn't do that. There we go. Now I go here. That's green. Christmas colors. Now we got some Christmas colors there. But this is how you can operate your flipper zero as if it were a battery. And you can make a whole bunch of LEDs light up. Now, like I said before, the other GPIOs I used for the RGBs, they're just, I'd say they're the pull-up and pull-down resistors. As I've learned off my Raspberry Pi, it has similar things where I can actually plug LEDs into my breadboard without having to use resistors. But I like using them because it's something you need to use in real life anyway. But these here, I didn't need a resistor because they're even pull-up and pull-down resistors. But they're just as bright, you wouldn't know anything was even there. But that's how it goes. And now if I want, I can turn all on. I'll show you. We'll go to here, and all the LEDs will turn white. See the word all? Now watch this. See that? Now again, I can pull away, and that's what you got. And that, my friends, is Flipper Zero. That's Flipper Zero switch. Well, guys, I think I'm going to cut this video now. And I hope that this all helped you. And I'll probably do more the more I know about this Flipper Zero. But now I'm going to definitely take time and learn how to solder. I have to do that much, I have to do that. Well, it's actually been kind of slowing me down. But this is how you have the Flipper Zero become a 5-volt battery to power all your LEDs or anything you want. You can actually use anything up to 5 volts. So there you have it, and I hope it's helped. Thank you for being here for me. Bye-bye for now.